Good afternoon, students. So now we will understand the concept of reflection and symmetry. So line symmetry and mirror reflection are naturally related and linked to each other. Here is a picture showing the reflection of the English letter M. You can imagine that the mirror is invisible and can just see the letter M and its images. You can see here, this is the mirror and this is the letter M. So the exact image we are getting in this mirror. Okay, if you see like this, this is your object and where the M is written, and this is your image where M is written. So this is your reflection symmetry, because you are observing the same object in the image in mirror. The object and its image are symmetrical with reference to the mirror line. Okay, if the paper is folded, the mirror line becomes the line of symmetry, and we then say that the image is the reflection of the object in the mirror line. Okay, so you can also see that when an object is reflected, there is no change in the lengths and angles, that is the length and angles of the object, and the corresponding lengths and angles of the image are the same. However, in one aspect there is a change, that is there is a difference between the object and image. Can you guess what the difference is? Obviously, when you see yourself in mirror and when you raise your left hand, but when you observe the image in the mirror, you observe that your right hand is raised. So there is change in left and right. Okay, same way when you raise your left hand in image, you can see your right hand. So this is the difference between the object and image. Otherwise, image and object are looks alike, they are symmetrical to each other except this left right position. Okay, okay, now see, you have given this, compare the lines of AB. So when you want to draw the exact image of this here, so what we have to do, we have to just measure the length of AB. The same measurement we can draw over here. Here 2 square has been left, so we have to left this 2 square, measure the length, we have to measure the angle, the same angle we have to draw over here, then we have to measure the length of B to C, and same we have to draw here. So this way we can draw the exact symmetrical image. Okay, now paper decoration. So this you have already learned in art and craft, that when you fold a paper and just draw an image, the same image you will get for the other side also. So this is identical. If you just draw the line from the middle, so this part and this part are identical. If you can just draw line like this, then also these two are identical. So this way, use this rectangular color paper, fold it several times and create some interactive patterns that you have already done, and you have already done in art and craft. So this, we can form identical symmetrical images with the help of paper cutting. Then this is the kaleidoscope. A kaleidoscope uses mirrors to produce images that have several lines of symmetry, as shown in the figure. Usually two mirror strips forming a V shapes are used, this one, and the angle between the mirrors determines the number of lines of symmetry. Okay, make a kaleidoscope and try to learn more about the symmetrical images. Here you have three angles, so you are getting the three symmetrical images. Okay, if you have a six angles like this hexagon, then you are getting six lines of symmetries, because we know that in equilateral triangle three line segments are there, so three line symmetries we are getting. In hexagon six line segments are there, so we are getting six lines of symmetry. Next we have select symmetrical designs you come across and prepare an album. So this is your symmetrical designs. Why? Because when you draw line of symmetry like this, from this, they both the parts are identical, from here and from here also you can draw the lines of symmetry. This is also a paper image. When you draw the lines like this, this you are getting, these two parts are symmetrical. If you draw like this, then also this is, both the parts are symmetrical. Same way here, how many from the middle also you can draw. Try to draw it by yourself. You are getting many lines of symmetry. Okay, next we have applications of reflection symmetry. So paper delivery boy wants to park his cycle at the some point P. Here is the P on the street and delivers the newspapers to house A and B. Where should be the park the cycle so that his walking distance will be least. Least matlab lower. You can use reflection symmetry here. Let A dash be the image of A in the mirror line, which is the street here. Then the point P is the ideal place to park the cycle. Means you have to just measure the distance, which one is the least distance. For that, what we have to do, we have to draw this imaginary line. This is your mirror line of symmetry. So the distance will be least, according to that you have to park your cycle. So this is your reflection symmetry. We have to guess, we have to imagine where we have to park our cycle so that the distance will be least. Okay, now we will discuss exercise 13.3. find the symmetry of lines of symmetry, number of lines of symmetry in each of the following shapes. How will you check your answers? So we can just paste the same, trace the same diagram in your paper and try to fold it. Whatever folding you are getting, that becomes your line of symmetry. Or rather, folding, you can just draw the line of symmetry this way. So these two are identical or symmetric. If you draw like this, then also upper and lower portion are identical. When you draw like this, so how many lines of symmetry you are getting? 4. Here from the middle, if you draw the line, so it is your line of symmetry. So how many lines? 1. From here, you can draw the line of symmetry. This one is, both the parts are identical. So first, second. So two lines of symmetries are there. Here, if you want to draw the line, one is already given. This is your one line of symmetry. Both the parts are identical. And next, you can draw from the middle. So, two lines of symmetry you are getting. Next, we have draw the lines from the middle. So, one line of symmetry we are getting. Here, draw the line of symmetry horizontally and vertically. So, you are getting two lines of symmetry. So this way we can find the number of lines of symmetry. Question number 2. Copy the following drawings on square paper and complete each one of them such that the resulting figure has two dotted lines as two lines of symmetry. So we start from here. So 1, 2, 3. So from here also 1, 2, 3. So this is our point. Then from here 1, 2, 3. So this is our point. So what we have to do? Join this and these two points. Then this two points and then these two points. So we are getting whatever diagrams we are getting. So it has four lines of symmetry. Next we have this one. So we exactly copy one. Then what we have to do? Like this and then again this one. Same way, one. So you are getting the same identical diagrams and it has four lines of symmetry. Same way here, we exactly copy whatever given this side. Same we do for the next time. Okay, this way we can complete our. So we are getting only one line of symmetry, that is from the middle. Next we have this one, then this two we have to cover and then this one. Again we do the same thing, two, so two, then this one, this one. Here two we have to complete. So we are completing this and we are getting here how many lines of symmetry? 2 lines of symmetry. Same way, try to complete these 2 diagrams by yourself. So this way we can complete this question number 2. Next we have, in each figure alongside a letter of the alphabet is shown along with a vertical line, take the mirror image of the letter in the given line. So we have to take the mirror image, this is your A, the mirror image we have to take over here. Same way B, the mirror image we have to take over here. So see, A will, we will get the A exactly, but for B, the mirror image should be like this, opposite. Okay? For O it is okay, but for E we are getting the mirror image like this. It's opposite. And we are getting like this. For P we are getting like this. H as it is, for L we are getting like this. T as it is, for S we are getting like this. For V as it is and X as it is. These are the mirror images. Try to do it by yourself. Keep a mirror. Write the letter and here you have to keep a mirror and see exactly what is the image, how it looks like. Okay, so try to do this by yourself. Here we have given some rangoli patterns. Okay, we have to keep a dots and symmetrically we have to join all the dots to make a particular diagram. So this is, you have to just observe it. Okay, so here your exercise and as well as the chapter is also completed. Any query you can ask me and most probably I will provide you the answer key for this 13.1, 2 and 3. Okay, thank you.